Well, hello everybody, I'm Nathaniel Dodson from tutvid.com. Welcome into this Adobe After Effects tutorial, where today we're going to take a look at five very basic, simple animations that are perfect if you're just getting started in Adobe After Effects. You're going to learn a whole lot about animation here. If you do enjoy this tutorial, well, make sure you subscribe to my channel so you never miss any future video editing, After Effects, Adobe Premiere Pro, you name it, tutorials. And without further ado, let's jump in and get this thing started. Alrighty, here in After Effects, I'm working with a new composition that I've sized to 2560 by 1440, and I'm at 60 frames per second as well. If you're creating a new composition to follow along, go ahead and use these settings. You can also go to Composition, Composition Settings, and change the settings of an already existing composition in there. I also have my background color set to the hex code 333333. It's just a pretty dark gray. I also added this little image to the background. I set its opacity to 5%, locked the background down so it doesn't move or I don't accidentally adjust it. It's not really part of this tutorial. I just if you're looking at it and you see it there, that's what's going on. Here's where the good stuff begins. All right, let's grab the text tool and type out the words or the number in the word 5 easy. And over in the character panel, I'm going to choose Bebas Bold as my font. I'm going to set it to 350 pixels in size. And then I'm going to use my align panel to center this text to my current composition. Now I'm going to add some more text by using the type tool again. I'm going to type out the word animations. Once again, I'm going to use Bebas Bold, a separate piece of text, of course. But this time, the text is going to be a size of 195 pixels. And again, I'm going to align this to the middle of my composition. And I'm going to drag it below my first piece of text to give a little spacing, just as much spacing as you think is right. I'm going to add a little bit here as I see fit. Once again, I'm going to add even more text by typing in this time in After Effects. And I'm going to, again, use Bebas Bold. I'm going to change the size here to 113 pixels. Again, I'll align this to the center of my composition and adjust the vertical positioning just to give a little space here as well. So just make sure all this text is spaced out nicely. After that, I can grab the ellipse tool and drag out a perfect circle. I can do that by holding down the shift key. And here, I'm up in the top bar, I'm going to choose to give it a white stroke. I don't want it to have a fill, so I can click on the word fill and just, you know, make sure I hit the slash in there. I'm going to add a 25 pixel white stroke to this shape. So you can select stroke, make sure it's filled with solid white, and then choose to make sure it's 25 pixels. Here again, we'll use the align panel and we'll get the horizontal and vertical centers aligned to this composition. And you can adjust it just a little bit or adjust your text to make sure your text is perfectly in the middle of this ellipse. Now grab all three pieces of text. In order to align this text, you may need to first lock the ellipse layer so you don't select it because technically it is on top of all this stuff. And then just shift-click the three pieces of text and you can nudge them up or down, like I said, just to make sure they get really into the center of the circle. So let's get animating here. I'm going to select the largest piece of text, the 5 easy, but I'm going to select it down in the layers area and I'm going to hit the letter S. That's going to bring up my scaling options. Then I'll click on that little stopwatch icon right there and that's going to drop a keyframe and allow me to start animating. Keyframes are essential. They're the little stopping points in our animation. I'm going to set the scaling here to 0%. It's going to make the text disappear. Don't worry. And then we're going to move out a little bit. When I say move out, I'm just dragging my playhead down the timeline a little bit. I have my playhead all the way at the first frame. I'm going to drag my playhead down the timeline just a little bit. It doesn't have to be too far, but you could stretch it out as much as you like. This part is kind of up to you. Wherever you see fit. And then I'm going to change the scaling back to 100%. And After Effects will auto add a new keyframe and fill in the animation between those keyframes. But you can see here when we play through this zooming animation, it looks bad because it begins at the bottom left corner and zooms in from there. I want it to look like a natural zoom up from the middle. What is going on here? Well, see this little node thing right here? That's the anchor point. And the scaling is done really based upon where this point is. If this point were in the middle of the text, we'd scale right from the center and get a proper zooming effect like we want. Good news is we can change this. It's a little weird, but we can change it. All we need to do is hold down the Command and Option keys, or on the Windows, the Control and Alt keys, and double-click this tool up here in the top toolbar. It's called the Pan Behind tool. It's up here in the toolbar at the top of our screen, and you can watch the point move, boom, right to the middle of, or right to the center of our text. And now when we play through the animation, we don't even need to reanimate anything. It works exactly like we want, except that it's still pretty mechanical and maybe a little blocky looking. That's because we need to add something called easing. So let's add some easing to make it look a little smoother and more natural. I'm going to select both keyframes by shift-clicking them, and then I will right-click on one of the keyframes and choose Keyframe Assistant, and then Easy Ease. This is going to make the whole animation much nicer, smoother, and just more professional. Let's move along to another type of animation here, a fade animation. I'll leave the 5 Easy layer open so I can see the keyframes down there. I'm talking about leaving it open down here in the Layers panel. And then I'll open the Animations layer. And I'm going to move the playhead to where the 5 Easy animation stops. And I'm going to hit the letter T to bring up the opacity option. And I'm going to drop a keyframe here by once again clicking on that little stopwatch icon. And I will choose to reduce the opacity to 0%. This is going to make our text disappear. Then I'll move the playhead down the timeline a little bit, however far we want. And I'll change the opacity back to 100. Select both of these new keyframes. We're going to do that same easy ease trick. It all looks pretty good. Now that we've got our first two animations down, let's do a pop-out animation with sort of an added bounce effect at the end of the animation. We're going to take things a little step further here now that we've gotten two basic animations down. Select the With After Effects layer down in the Layers area and hit S to once again open up scaling. And once more, I will hold down the Command Option or Control Alt key, and I'm going to double-click that Pan Behind tool. Again, that's just to reset my anchor point to the center of this piece of text. And then I'm going to drop a keyframe by clicking on the stopwatch icon where on the timeline the fade-in animation completes. Then I'm going to go and I'm going to deselect that little chain link icon here between my scaling. This is between the X and the Y axis. This is going to allow us to change the scaling of just one axis of our text while not messing around with the other. I want to reduce the X axis scale to 0%. And move the playhead down the timeline a little bit and reset the X scale to 100%. This will give us this effect where the text is just sort of shooting out side to side from the center of this piece of text. It's a really neat little animation. Now what I want to do is select both of those keyframes again by shift-clicking them, add that Easy Ease by right-clicking, and go down to the Keyframe Assistant and choose to apply that same Easy Ease to these keyframes as well. But with these keyframes still selected, we're going to click on this little graph editor icon to bring up this kind of complicated-looking graph. But this is where the magic happens. I'll drag this little handle and pull the red line up past the dashed line. This will tell After Effects to kind of to overextend the animation before letting it slide or snap back to the proper 100% size. We can tweak this graph line here to perfect the easing as well if we want. Now, let's click on the graph editor icon to get back to the original timeline. I'll preview the effect and see how it's looking. Pretty, pretty cool. There's so many great applications for this effect. Definitely something you want to remember. Now let's animate our circle to draw around this text as soon as it finishes appearing. That is, as soon as the text finishes appearing. I'm going to unlock the shape layer and twirl down the little arrow and find contents and twirl that down and get down into ellipse 1. I'm going to hit the little arrow next to add right there in sort of the top right corner, if you will, of that layer. And I'm going to choose to add a trim paths here. Move the playhead to where the text animation finishes on your timeline and reduce the end parameter to 0%. This is going to sort of zip up and hide the entire ellipse stroke. Then just move the playhead a little further down the timeline, set the end parameter to 100%, and let After Effects do the auto keyframing and animation magic for you. Let's go ahead and preview this effect at this point, and it's looking pretty good. I think I'm going to select both of my keyframes here and move this animation back so it takes place kind of as the final piece of text is animating in to help this whole animation feel just a little bit tighter and more well put together. We can also select both these keyframes and add an easy ease to really complete the animation here. Now, there are also a ton of great animation possibilities within some of the pretty amazing effects offered in After Effects. So let's do something cool here. Right-click within the Layers area and choose to create a new, and within the new menu, choose Solid. And let's name this Solid Waves. Now, we're going to open up the Effects and Presets panel by going Window, Effects and Presets, and I'm going to run a search for an effect called Radio Waves. Then I'm going to drag that out and just drop it onto our solid. Then we're going to look for our Effect Controls panel. Again, if it's not open, Window, Effect Controls. I've got mine over here on the left, and I'm going to make some changes in here. First of all, I'm going to change the frequency to 4. I'm going to change the expansion to 25. Lifespan, we'll shift that to 1.2. I want the color to be white. And I'm going to set the opacity to 0.25, which is 25%. This runs from a 0 to 1 scale here on opacity. I'm going to change the start width to 20, and the end width, I'm going to set it to 1. Now what I'll do is I'll drag the solid on the timeline. I'll drag the edge so this whole radio wave nonsense begins right where all the other animation completes. There may be some better ways to do this, but this is kind of just a quick and dirty way to make this work for the time being. So I'll go ahead and I'll preview this. And I can watch the entire series of animations that we covered here today all take effect and play out before my eyes. And I think it looks pretty good for a series of beginner-level animations. We talked about a simple zoom animation, a fade-in animation, a one-axis scale animation, adding that cool little easing bump effect, and of course, this really cool repeating wave animation from the radio waves effect. So that, my friends, I believe will wrap this one up for learning about keyframes and stopwatch icons and easing and bumping and all the little things we cover in this video tutorial. Guys, that's it. Get it? Got it? Good. Nathaniel Dodson, tutvid.com. I'll catch you in the next one. And before you go, make sure you subscribe to my channel for more great tutorials every day. Also, buy my course. It helps us do what we do, and this channel is supported by viewers just like you. You can also just click the thumbnail and watch another video from this channel. See you next time, guys.